Cat girls are harder to kidnap. Blow in her face and she'll follow you anyway. My clock just died. Can I bury it in your backyard? We only break for pussy. I'm happy as a fish with a clock in her mouth. Some of the more disturbing ones, I found this one quite disturbing, was 90% of priests who tried camels prefer young boys. Now I do know that a girl who had been sexually assaulted found herself behind that man and burst into tears and was triggered. I often like to drown my sorrows, but I can't get my wife to go swimming. The thing with these things is to play on words. We find it funny. A few people do that. Oh, that's a kind of funny way of seeing it. But what I want to confirm is that even if it's not a sexual act, we are imagining. What are we imagining? So when my daughter saw inside every princess is a little slut who wants to try it just once, I pictured an old pedophile looking at my child. Someone of a similar age to my daughter, and wanting to have sex with her because she's a little slut deep down inside. These are the things we're imagining. We're imagining oral sex as we're driving down the street with our children. So these words are offensive as I'm saying them now. Imagine, they're in our public sweat. So this is not, do you think it's funny, do you share that joke with your mates? Well, if you share that joke with your mates, well, there's nothing I can do about that. But I can argue and fight about the fact that they're in our public space. There's a difference. Public space, we have a right not to have to be exposed to these toxic ideas. So here we are, a year later. I found this speech hard to write, funnily enough. I can talk under water, generally, for hours. My students are all there, I've talked about. But I found this one hard because 127,000 plus votes were gained in 4 days. 133 articles were written around the world, including the Huffington Post. I was on the project with my daughter. I did 15 radio interviews. Wicked Campervan called Uncle. We will do what you say. Funnily enough, they covered one van, the van my daughter saw. They spread over one van. He wrote over that man, if only Noah had slaughtered those two mosquitoes. Friends of mine said, are you and your daughter the mosquitoes? And I said, I'll take it. I'll take that. Because Lucy Clark, who wrote an article in the Courier Mail a few years ago, John Webb wrote, dear Lucy, you can see the gaffer tape over your mouth. So it's an actual violent threat. Nothing was wrong. So I thought, yeah, I'll take the mosquito. The amazing warrior with the Pickets have gone to the Attorney General. I have gone to the Shadow Communications Minister, John Clare. He is now running through the letter to the Attorney General up here in Queensland, supporting changes to laws to get the Advertising Standards Bureau to be able to report. To be able to actually find them. What else have we had? Verna Green around the Newcastle area on our state had Malcolm Turnbull. So we've got to find Malcolm Turnbull. He has agreed to meet with you and Jeremy Bolly of the AFP and see if we can also get some sort of involvement to happen. We also have to follow. So we're getting there, but it hasn't happened yet.
Just let us know.
So, John Webb gave me a gift by John Williams Spinner because he did not pull up his hands and say, I have got a change of heart. He got an email every time someone signed that petition. So he got tens of thousands of emails flooding his inbox and he just went, I can't do business like this. All right, yeah, we'll do what you say. So we were a mosquito. So we can still be a mosquito, but we need a swarm. I've done a few things, I've suggested a few things. People generally are a bystander. And that's where I found it hard today to write this speech because I find that the apathy of the general person is our biggest problem. We can find this. It's just a guy. It's just a guy putting things along the slope and he's making money. But we need to be a mosquito. We need to join together and just do everything. doesn't know what species and what isn't, that would annoy him. I'd love to annoy him. That would be cool. So don't be bystanders. Call it out. Personally, I'm a high school teacher of 20 years and I've started a business on it part-time. I took a leap of faith and did that part-time this year to teach students media literacy, using critical thinking. It's not about the emotion of what they're seeing, it's about them looking at it like aliens.
Yes, I should sign the petition. That's very good. I won't show the name. That's right. It's a good idea. Petitions are very underrated.
There's a bit of sympathy with a couple of current AFP colleagues. There's Jennifer Allen is going to take this petition today. She's up at Ipswich. Also, Shannon Fenneman's quite on site too.
Well, Anna Rice, but I think